name is Donna Stein, and this event is the ninth. This event is the ninth annual New York City Friends of Clearwater Water Festival. We have today at this event we have a wonderful group of performers and speakers, and I think you're going to be really pleased with the day. You know, there's so much information on peace, nuclear disasters, dangers, fossil fuel, build-out, and trade deals to speak on, but this day we're going to be focusing on the fact that we are not going anywhere, that there will always be a resistance standing up for what is the greater good. We're going to stand up for peace, safe energy, climate justice, and true fair trade that makes the planet livable for all. Okay? There have been struggles that preceded us, and future generations will continue to resist. That is who we are as humans. I have a belief that we will persist and resist until some ideal day when it doesn't feel like a struggle, and the focus will change to encouraging people to not be completely complacent.
I want to say a couple words about New York City Friends of Clearwater. So the exact origins of New York City Friends of Clearwater are kind of lost in the mist of time, but we've been around for about 40 years, since the mid-70s. And we are a chartered sloop club of the Hudson River Sloop Clearwater. You're probably all familiar with that wonderful boat, the Clearwater. There's pictures around here somewhere. At least a drawing of the Clearwater in our logo. So the Clearwater sailed into New York City for the first time in May of 1969 and has been sailing strong ever since. This summer, they went down to Washington to lobby for the environment. And we've been supporting the mission of Clearwater for all this time, and you know, and here at the festival. And the New York City Friends of Clearwater, you're all invited to get involved. Those of you who have been already involved and those who haven't. We meet, we have a general meeting every month, usually at the Judson Square Church, right south, one block south of Washington Square Park, 239 Thompson Street in Manhattan. And it's usually on the third Friday of each month. Hope to see you all there, and hope to see you at all our events. Thank you so much for coming.
So today is all about celebrating our victories and understanding that vigilance and persistence is necessary. But I'd like to think that somebody can change your day. I mean, let's face it, this work that we do will never be finished. It'll never be done. So if you're looking for that final victory, I'm sorry, but it's not going to happen that way. And sometimes you need to be reminded while you're working so hard and things aren't going well that you are making a difference. Did you ever feel afraid about the progress that you made? You didn't think you would escape to see it through, but you hung on just the same, and you learned to play the game, and in the end you made a friend or two. This is your part. Just to share, and the fact that you were there, and now your future never looked so bright. That's right. Anyone can do it. Anyone can do it. If anyone can do it, you can do it too. Anyone can do it. So unclear. Faith gives way to fear. And what a perilous struggle to be free. You gotta organize today. It seems that's the only way we can get close to where we want to be. You see, just the same, and you learn to play the game, and in the end, you made a friend, or two, or three, or four, or more. Anyone can do it, anyone can do it, anyone can do it, you can do it too. Anyone can do it,
Trans-Pacific Partnership. That's a real example of how grassroots organizing, regular people struggling together, making the links with other people in other communities, in other countries, among other nations, coming together for a goal. So it's hard work. It's really hard work. But remember, the whole plan behind the Trans-Pacific Partnership was, let's just sneak it through under the radar. Nobody will know what's coming. And a lot of our battle was just letting people know about it. For the first 3 years I was active on it, it was mostly not only lobbying our congressional representatives, that was actually only a very small part of it. It was mostly just going out into communities, having meetings, talking to people, going to events. And you would tell people about it, and they go, I'm outraged. What can I do? So people who aren't even politically engaged wanted to do something about it. They were so outraged when they heard about this. So. Just by shining a spotlight and doing this, we did a lot. So we can defeat things. Okay, now we've got NAFTA. Now we've got the Trade and Services Agreement. We've got the Transatlantic Agreement between the U.S. and the European Union. There are lots of people on the case in Europe. Lots of grassroots activity going on. So there's always going to be another fight. But we can win. How about in 2001 when Giuliani wanted to bombard all of New York City with very dangerous pesticides, with pyrethroids, cancer-causing agents, and they're just going to spray indiscriminately the entire city. And I was one of the founders of the No Spray Coalition that put a stop to that. And we made it, not only did the city couldn't do that, but the city would put out bids to professional exterminators who had the capacity to do this, and no one would even bid on it because why? Grassroots activists made it politically impossible for them to do it. Now, that doesn't mean that there's no spraying going on. There's always a little bits here and there, but it's not a mass spray. So there's an example of a tangible victory.
not easy, but I can't help falling in love with me. I'm the star of the GOP, and they can't help falling in love with me. And the lemmings march surely to the sea. Politics is just reality TV. Ratings win, not my policy. And they can't help falling in love with me. As the polling goes, resentment has its way, and the anger grows. It doesn't matter what I say. So vote your rage. It's a way to be. And you can't help falling in love with me. And I can't help falling in love with me. Thank me. Thank me. So how do you respond to a song like that? Well, there are many ways. Let me count the ways. Here's one of them. Play bass, it's in D. Your tweeting heart will make us weep. It's 5 a.m. Please go to sleep. These things you do just bring me pain. Your posts are brief, just like your brain. The truth is plain for all to see. One day of dry and your cold security. Please take his phone. Your tweeting heart, leave me alone. You fought with friends and allies too. Something is wrong. It must be you. Your tweeting heart will make us weep. It's 5 a.m. Please, for God's sakes, go to sleep. These things you do just brings more pain. Your tweeting heart, our ball and chain. Your tweeting heart, oh, not again. where she got her sense of fashion. It wasn't me. Well, every so often, and not enough, every so often, topical songwriters have to retire a song. You write a song about an injustice, and then things get better, and you lose a perfectly good song. I mean, really. Maybe this is the last time we have to sing this one. There's a place called Indian Park. It's an unsafe nuclear joint. It threatens everybody and poisons everything. It's worst on a public safety list. It's a target for a terrorist. We have a chance to shut it down, and this is why we sing. This is your part. Kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. If we don't close Indian Point, kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. If we don't close Indian Point, kiss your ass goodbye. Great man to hear. Within 50 miles of where it is, 21 million people live. A good part of the country would be gone with one mistake, or a bomb, or an airplane. The question remains, who would gain? Jeopardizing people's lives, the chances that we take. It's kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. If we don't close Indian Point, kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. If we don't close Indian Point, kiss your ass goodbye. Now this thing about nuclear energy doesn't make much sense to me. After all, waste disposal is impossible, and the danger grows each day. It shows up in the baby teeth, in the air and the water underneath, treating everyone I know to live in fear and say, it's kiss your ass goodbye, kiss your ass goodbye. If we don't close any apart, kiss your ass goodbye, kiss your ass goodbye, kiss your ass goodbye. If you don't close any point, kiss your ass goodbye. Now they're asking us to believe, if things go wrong, then we can leave. Do they think we're stupid? No, there's no evacuation plan. Hell, you'd sit in traffic till you die, and all the time you'd wonder why. Why we didn't do things then, we gotta do it while we can. It's kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. If we don't close in the point, kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye. Last verse. You can't file an insurance claim.
No, you cannot.
You can't find someone else to blame. You will not be protected by those corporate rules and regs. So give yourself and life a chance. Disable nuclear bombs and plans. For you can bend right over, put your head between your legs, and kiss your ass goodbye.
Good throw!
Kiss your ass goodbye! If we don't close any point, kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye.
Kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye.
If you don't close into your point, kiss your ass goodbye. Kiss your ass goodbye.
About another issue.
Let's have
one. This one continues to go on in this country.
If you wanna put veins in your water, that will poison the folks that you know. If you want to drink chemical cocktails, that can light up a faucet and blow. If you want to depopulate neighborhoods, bringing property values to smash. If you thought about giving your future to gas in exchange for a small pile of cash, there is something that I want to tell you. If you want to be happy and free, don't frack with me. Don't frack with me. Go find some other biz, leave the shale as it is, and don't frack with me, don't frack with me. Don't frack with me. Leave the gas in the ground, we don't need it around. Don't frack with me. Now if you think that by this education, I'm being mean and unfair. Remember, there is no separation in our water and land and our air. You know, we're not allowed to know what they put in those chems that they use. That will tear up the soil so the gas can come out, legal secrets to hide and abuse. Hey, doesn't this sound suspicious? Haven't these companies lied before? And there's nothing that gives anyone rights to poison their neighbors next door. And if you cannot believe what I'm saying, take a good look around and you'll see there's a cost for the price we are paying. And don't frack with me, don't frack with me. Frack with me, don't frack with me.
Don't frack with me!
It's better to pass on this natural gas. Don't frack with me, don't frack with me.
Don't frack with me!
Don't frack with me.
Don't frack with me.
Make a hold on a stand for the water and land, and don't frack with me.
All right, I'm gonna need your help on this. The moose and moose. Keep it up now.
Times may be very hard. They'll put the money in your hands in this rigged game of cards. Halliburton and all of the others will hire men and boys to tear the soul out of the earth and leave the smell and noise. Oh, but you don't have to play this game. You're not alone this time. The Gulf rig taught us many things about greed and corporate crime. And now the moment's up to you. Who do you choose to be? In your heart you know what's right. Trust it and you'll be free. Don't crack with me.
Don't crack with me.
Don't crack with me.
Don't crack with me.
See through the lies and be brave, organize. Don't crack with me. Don't crack with me.
Don't crack with me.
Don't crack with me.
Don't crack with me.
Make your bold, honest stand for the water and land. Don't crack with me. Make your bold, honest stand for the water and land. Don't crack with me. Don't crack with me. When you're cracking, when you're fracking, your neighbors crack with you. When you're drinking stuff that's stinking, oh, that poison's coming through. Your health and family will not be the same when you're